I'm honored to be here to acknowledge my dear friend, Michael Lombardo, as the recipient of the HRC Visibility Award. Since our first meeting more than 4 years ago, I have felt not only deep respect for Mike, but deep comfort with him. He is curious, charming, even cozy, I would say, and it's a freaking delight when you can get him to laugh that awesome, awesome laugh. Side note, this comfort only became deeper when I ran into him in a lesbian spin class. A true camaraderie was born out of seeing him sweat, although I sweat way more. I also have to say that Mike gives the best notes in the world. Notes are never fun, but when it comes from Mike, you can trust this fact. Censorship has nothing to do with it. He believes deeply in each artist's right to show their truth, and sometimes that truth is ugly. He deeply wants each HBO program to be the most effective version of itself that it can be, so that it may be seen for its truth and hopefully, hopefully, enact real cultural change. Because of this dictate coming down from on high, HBO has long been a place known for inviting and welcoming the best creative voices in our industry, plus some random chubby girls. But more than that, I know I look really amazing tonight, but it's been a struggle. Thank you. But more than that, Michael supports and gives creative opportunities to those from the LGBT community, people of color, and women. He truly believes these diverse voices and the stories they tell matter, are necessary, that seeing yourself reflected back in popular culture is a right, not a privilege. We can all continue to honor Michael by remembering that daily. What many of you may not know is that in addition to the very public support displayed by Michael, he and his husband, Sonny, who is very handsome as well, are also advocates in their personal lives. They often open their home and their family in support of fundraisers and benefits to create awareness to the LGBT community. They will also allow any of you to come live there. All you have to do is prove you are really gay. As the nation's largest LGBT civil rights organization, I would like to thank Chad Griffin and the entire HRC staff for their crucial work in advocating the basic equal rights of the LGBT community. Their vision of seeing a country where the LGBT people can be open, honest, and safe at home, at work, and in their communities is a stunning and necessary one. The progress we have made nationally on these issues is a true testament to their hard work and an example for millions across our nation. As many of you know, HBO has been producing award-winning programming that celebrates the LGBT community. Shows and films such as Looking, The Normal Heart, Girls, which is on this list for reasons I don't fully understand since we mostly show hand jobs. And of course, the groundbreaking documentary, The Case Against Eight, which so many people here tonight had a pivotal role in producing. Michael's brilliant and benevolent leadership truly fosters a culture within the industry that allows us creative types to present work that reflects our most personal truths. Whenever I tell anyone I work at HBO, their answer is a simple one, lucky you. And when I say Mike Lombardo is my caseworker, they consider me even luckier. Michael, so many of us here love you deeply and have been touched by you. So many people here love you deeply, and you have touched and changed our lives in ways you can't imagine. Something was gonna happen. It is such an honor for us to honor you. Let's take a look at the times Mike Lombardo touched us.
I think everyone's a homosexual.
Most people are.
You told me Barack Obama was gay.
He reads bi.
He's always looking for ways to expand the horizons.
He puts his heart behind his name.
You know I love you.
Michael deserves so much credit for many of the shows that America watches.
I first met Mike Lombardo because of our very exciting sex life together. I'm talking about Sex in the City.
Oh, What was that?
A preview?
Michael Lombardo is a risk taker.
Under his watch, HBO has become a place for the kinds of stories that couldn't be told on other networks.
With a normal heart, Michael had the courage to do it where no one else did.
It's still very rare to have a show on television that's all about gay people.
Where they're seen as human beings and not sexually sensationalized, but as well-rounded people.
Through his work at GLSEN and through his work at HBO, he has made elements of our experience sing.
He said the burger might have AIDS.
I'm an American, and I got a say in who makes my food.
Bitch, you come in my house, you gonna eat my food the way I make it! Tip your waitress.
He's certainly open to characters of any particular kind of sexuality. And it doesn't have to be drama based in reality. It can be based in fantasy, like True Blood, like Game of Thrones. I'm very, very thankful that he was willing to take a shot on True Blood.
His support of our show has been unwavering from the beginning. Every time he has a note, I listen to it because he's the smartest man in town.
I don't think there's anybody better to sit in the chair and balance the responsibility to both entertain and the responsibility to inform and enlighten than Mike.
Why don't you come work for me?
As what?
I had a script called Behind a Candelabra and showed it to all the studios. Nobody wanted to make it. I didn't make it to change the world. It's a love story. And it could be two men, two women, a man and a woman, and whatever it is. And Michael understood that. He got it.
Where's this big mouth I hear you've got?
The big mouth a symptom?
No, it's a cure.
He came over to my cutting room and cried along with me as we were watching it because he was very emotional about it, which I loved. You know, he's a very emotional guy, and yet he's also very business-minded. Michael and I had a couple discussions about the sex scenes, where I believe his opening salvo about that was, Ryan, come on, really? Do you really need an extra blowjob? So I cut it, of course, because he was right.
Their love is true. I know that they deserve full equality.
He takes risks on filmmakers like myself who might not have the longest track record.
He gave us the freedom to make the film that we wanted to make, and he gave us the advocacy and the resources to reach millions of families around the country.
It's well known that Michael and Sonny and their family played a pretty pivotal role in the seismic shift that we've seen in marriage equality, especially within the presidential administration.
And I don't think he would call himself an activist. I think he would sort of see himself more as a supporter of good causes.
Every person who walks through our doors has a story, a personal story. And Michael really gets that.
Not only does he really care about the arts, he cares about the opportunity for all people to have access to the arts.
Commitment looks good on you.
He insisted on living his life as an openly gay man, married with children.
He finds time for the family and for me and throughout all of that hard work. He's a very serious person, but at the same time, he has a very fun side to him as well. He definitely likes a lot of reality television.
It's HBO. Not that many people are going to see it.
What does the Visibility Award mean if you're being honored? It means that you've made enough other people visible that it's reflecting back on you.
Congratulations, Michael, on receiving the Visibility Award from the Human Rights Campaign.
Thank you so much for your leadership.
You deserve all the honors in the world.
This is so incredibly well-deserved.
Warmest congratulations to you.
The Human Rights Campaign is fortunate to have you.
Congratulations, Dad. We love you.
Mike, we're so proud of you. I'm so proud of you.
The world needs more people like you.
We told him the video would be moving. Please welcome my friend and our HRC Visibility Award recipient, Michael Lombardo.
Each time that I think you go, I turn around and you're creeping in. And I let you under my skin, cause I love living in the sin. Oh, you never told me true love was gonna hurt. True pain I don't deserve. Truth is that I never learned.
Wow. Thank you, Lena. You are smart.
and beautiful and talented and fearless and fierce, and I love you. Thank you, Chad, and the leadership of HRC. The Visibility Award. When I was first approached about accepting this award, I was a little bit surprised, a little bit embarrassed, and very honored. I was surprised because I haven't broken any records or lived life in public service or argued before the Supreme Court or come out on a talk show. Embarrassed because I have been incredibly blessed, some would say lucky, to live the life I have. But ultimately, I felt humbled. I mean, being recognized for something that is seemingly so simple, living my life honestly and openly, is really the highest achievement I can have hoped for. It's one that I never would have dreamt possible when I came out to myself and my family those many years ago. Hey guys, my kids are here. oh my gosh. As I was set to embark on a career as a young lawyer in the 1980s, a well-meaning gay professor at my law school, who I had looked to as a mentor, gave me some advice. He told me that I could be successful as long as I would never admit to anybody that I was gay. He said people could conjecture and whisper and probe, and that might be annoying, but it wouldn't be professionally fatal as long as I was discreet and as long as I kept my personal life very personal. I guess, however shocked I was, I understood it. There were no openly gay or lesbian partners at major law firms. There were no gay corporate titans or gay judges or media executives or even openly gay or lesbian school teachers. Professional achievement by traditional standards seemed completely at odds with being open, no less proud to live life as a gay man or woman. I had this fantasy that I could do it a different way. I didn't know how and I didn't know when, but the thought of living two lives, a personal and a professional, just felt like a death sentence to me. That I'm standing here today accepting this award is a huge personal achievement, and it really is an honor to the men and women who have helped me get here. The blessings I have today in terms of self-acceptance and stepping out of the shadows are due in no small part to the hundreds of thousands of gay men who died during the first decade of the AIDS crisis, and to the many men and women I witnessed caring, loving, grieving, and fighting for them. The anger and fear and love and pride I felt during that period changed me. It made the idea of living in the shadows somehow unconscionable. The idea of not standing up to confront bigotry and hatred and social injustice just felt like it would dishonor everything I had witnessed. So to the men and women who we buried and the men and women who stood up during that time, I thank you. I was also blessed to have made a seemingly rash and yet defining career move in the 80s. I was so desperate to leave the practice of law at a large corporate law firm that I accepted a job at this very odd company with an odd name called Home Box Office. You know, what I found there was a group of people just like me, refugees of old boy corporate cultures. It was a company, even in the 80s, with female senior executives, and dare I say it, a couple of openly gay professionals. I found a home where I could breathe. I found colleagues who not only accepted me for who I was, but embraced me. So to the men and women of HBO who have given me a home for 30 years, who have fostered an atmosphere of tolerance and respect, not only in the programming, but in the hallways and conference rooms and offices, I thank you. Much of the reason I'm honored here tonight, as you can see, is the incredible programming that I have had the distinction of representing. But the secret, if it is a secret, is that I'm not the real honoree. I have been blessed to work with an incredibly talented group of writers, directors, producers, and actors, many of whom are here tonight. Together, they have created a tapestry of interesting, moving, and honest films and documentaries and series in which the lives and truths of LGBT characters are reflected. So to all of you, and to those who couldn't attend, I thank you, I stand here, and I take a bow in your honor. Thank you. But finally, the luckiest and most fortunate event in my life was a personal one. It was meeting the man with whom I would build my family. You know, 30 years ago, I had been told that not only would I be honored with a visibility award, but I'd be doing it in front of a man who was not only my best friend, but my legally recognized husband. I would have assumed that someone had ingested massive quantities of psychotropic drugs. And yet here I am standing in front of Sonny Ward, my husband, a man who loves me, grounds me, supports me, and encourages me to be the best version of myself. Thank you, Sonny. Together with our children, Josie and Johnny, who are here tonight, we have created a family and a home that is really my truest blessing. I wouldn't be who I am without you. I suppose in many ways, my own journey mirrors that of a whole generation of LGBT Americans, a journey toward visibility and acceptance. But the journey for all of us, as we've heard tonight, is far from over. That is why it is important for all of us to stand up and be counted, to speak up against social injustice, and to love who we love proudly and fiercely and openly. Because at the end of the day, those are the most powerful weapons we have against hate and intolerance. Thank you to the HRC for this award, for the work you do, and continue to do to light the path for us. Thank you to my friends and loved ones for being here tonight. Your presence means more than you could know. Thank you very much.